Hey friends, it's Amy and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be another what is life like in Bahrain type video, and it's been a while since I've made one of these just because I've been so obsessed and all consumed with my no buy year that I've been making a lot of content about that. So I needed to like control myself, take a step back from the no buy year, and you know, make some other types of videos. So that's what we're gonna do today. And specifically in this video, I'm going to be talking about five things that really just get under my skin about living in Bahrain. If you are new to this channel and you haven't seen any of my other life in Bahrain type videos before, then please, before you watch this, go ahead and watch at least one of those. I will link them down below, because in every video, all I talk about is how much I love Bahrain. So I would hate for someone new to this channel to come here and think that I'm just like bad mouthing Bahrain, that I don't want to be here, that I hate it here, because as everyone who's been here before knows, I love Bahrain. I love living here. I think there are so many positives to being here. And I always talk about the positive sides, but with anything in life, there are pros and there are cons. And today, we're gonna talk about some things that just get on my nerves about living here, and I hope that's okay. Before we get in, I just wanna make it very clear that by no means are these big, earth-shattering grievances. These are really small daily irritants that are pretty insignificant. But I just thought this video could be a little bit of fun. It's meant to be lighthearted. Don't take it too seriously. Don't tell me to go kill myself, okay? One last thing before we actually get into the video. I am aware that my hair looks like a bush. Please send help. If you are living in Bahrain right now and you can recommend a good salon for me to visit, please let me know, because this is not okay. I'll be looking in the comment section. Someone please send help. I need recommendations and a lot of TLC. But hair grievances aside, of which there are many, let's get into the five things that irritate me about living in Bahrain. Okay, the first rant, and yes, I am going to be ranting in this video. Get your ranting hats on, it's happening. But my first rant of like things that are just really ridiculous about living in Bahrain is that most of the coins are completely useless. In Bahrain, they have a 5 fils coin, a 10, a 25, a 50, and a 100. Now, the 25, the 50, and the 100, I have no qualms with. They can go about their lives, I'm not concerned about them. But the 5 and the 10, people won't accept them. When I try and pay in the supermarket, they tell me no, they don't accept those coins. When I try and give them to the Talabat delivery guy, he's like, no, I don't accept this money. People are acting like it's not real money. So why does it exist? And also, why do people feel like it's okay to give me change in 5s and 10s, but then I'm not able to like use them anywhere else? It's just such a weird concept to me, because in the UK, shops love it when you pay with change, because then they have change to give to other customers who need it. So if you try and pay with change in the UK, people are so happy about it. If you try and pay with change here, people like hate you. I remember when I first moved here and I didn't know the unspoken rule about the 5 and 10 coins and the fact that everyone hates them, but I think I had to make up like 75 fils, and I made it up in 5s and 10s because that just seemed like an acceptable thing to do. And then the waiter returned and he just slammed all the coins on the table. They went everywhere and we were all just like, what just happened? It's a thing. People don't want the 5s and 10s, but they will give them to you. So you end up with a jar full of useless money, which at the end of the day, we could just say, hey, let's stop producing 5 and 10 fils coins if we're not gonna treat them as legal tender. That was a rant. I have a lot of feelings about that. The next thing that kind of sucks about living in Bahrain is that you just can't get your post delivered. And I know I talked about this when I lived in Kuwait, because it was the same setup, same situation. It's just a nightmare. Like, don't expect anyone to be able to send you things in the post. Don't expect to be able to order online. Don't expect for even your bank card to come to the, in the post. Like, you have to go to the bank and pick it up when it comes in, because they won't post it to you because the post doesn't work. It's very frustrating and I just don't understand it. In the UK, we have the post office and the Royal Mail, and they're in charge of all the post. But I don't know that there is like a post office or like a national postal system here. I don't think that even exists. And then even when you use the private ones, the post does not turn up. Like, I've had so many packages just disappear into the abyss. So I've stopped trying to have things delivered. The only way I get things delivered now is diverting them from the UK to the US and then back to the Navy base here. That is the only way for me to get things delivered, which I guess is okay because it really does curb my online shopping, but it's pretty frustrating. The next thing that irritates me about living in Bahrain is the amount of catcalling and creepy guys just in the streets. At the end of the day, catcalling happens everywhere. It's an unfortunate reality of life. But here, it's just like a constant barrage of people like hollering out of their windows, beeping, like pulling up next to you on the side of the road. And let me give you an example of how extreme this is. So one day when I was still at my old job, I was walking to work. And when I go to work, I am covered from like neck to ankles to wrists, and I dress really baggy. And when I worked at my old job, I would just like scrape my hair back in a ponytail, no makeup, and I was just like the least attractive person on the streets. Seriously, I looked like I had just crawled out of a bin, like I was Oscar the Grouch's older, less attractive sister. And I'm there walking to work, and this car is like following me really slowly. And I'm like, what is this guy doing? And he just pulls up beside me, rolls down the window, and he looks at me like in complete seriousness. And is like, how much? And I mean, this was at like 6:30 in the morning. And I'm looking at him like, clearly I am not a prostitute. I'm here with a work bag full of kids' books. I've got my glasses on. I've got my hair scraped back in a ponytail. Like, I'm covered from head to foot. So if I was a prostitute, I don't know. I feel like that would be really bad marketing. Like, it wouldn't speak very highly of my business etiquette to look like that and go out. I don't know. It's weird. It's something that's very irritating, and it's something that I deal with pretty much on a daily basis. The next thing that sucks about living in Bahrain, I don't have such an intense rant about, so everyone can take a breath. It's the school hours. School here starts at 7 a.m. Does that seem ridiculously early to anyone else? Like, back when I was in the UK, one of the schools I worked at, it started at 9, one of them it started at 9:30, and then it still ends at around 3, because these schools are working from 7 until 3. That's really intense. And I mean, not just from a teacher's perspective, although I personally find it to be tiring, but for like small kids, for 6 and 7 year olds to be working from 7 a.m. until like 2:30 or 3, it just seems like a lot. And the last thing that irritates me about living in Bahrain is something that I think I've mentioned in a previous video, but I'm gonna mention it again because it is very annoying, and it is the traffic situation. I don't feel so terrified by the driving situation in Bahrain since I went to Jordan. If you guys saw that vlog where we legit almost died on the roads because the driving was so crazy, then you'll understand that having lived through that experience, I now feel less terrified on the Bahraini roads. But it still is kind of like every man for himself. And even the crazy driving aside, the traffic, especially on the weekends when the island just gets like full to capacity because everyone wants to come chill here because there's alcohol and drinking and dancing and, you know, the things that you can't do in like Saudi and Kuwait. So everyone comes here, all of a sudden there's like a bunch of new people, everyone's on the roads, no one can get everywhere, you're stuck in traffic forever, people are like driving up on the embankments because, hey, rules don't apply, right? And it's very scary, it's very frustrating. Okay everyone, those were my five things that suck about living in Bahrain, and I hope you could see through all of this, that this really was meant to just be like a lighthearted video. I'm not attacking Bahrain, and clearly these things that I've listed are not of any real importance. They're just little things that kind of irritate me on a daily basis that I thought it would be funny to share with you guys. So let's not get too emotionally invested in this video. If you guys enjoy these videos about expat life, living in the Middle East, all those kinds of things, please go ahead and let me know in the comment section down below. I haven't been making as much of these recently, like I said, but if it's something that you guys really like, then I will start upping the production of those. I don't know what this is. Yeah, but it's really important for me to know what kinds of videos you guys are interested in and what kinds of things you enjoy seeing, because I want you to come back. And on that note, if you haven't already, then please go ahead and subscribe to my channel, join the family, hit that little bell in the corner so that you don't miss another video. But until next time, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you all so much, and I will see you soon. Bye.